It's been like just a year ago since we reviewed this phone. This phone was the very first phone we reviewed on the Cyber Reviews channel, and this is the Huawei Y9 Prime 2019. And it's amazing how, like, in the space of a year, Huawei has moved from two cameras at the back to four cameras on the Huawei Nova 5T that we are going to talk about today. And from this plastic gradient finish to a glass back gradient finish, which is really, really beautiful. So I have these phones side by side. Here is the Huawei Y9 Prime 2019, and this is the Huawei Nova 5T. These phones are like years, just 1 year apart. And in that time, like within that period, we've moved from 4 gigs RAM to 8 gigs of RAM for almost the same price. We've moved from two cameras at the back to four cameras at the back, back mounted fingerprint sensor to a fingerprint sensor which is mounted in the power button. We've moved from two cameras in front to a hole punch camera on the front. Now, the reason why I went to buy the Huawei Nova 5T again is because this phone fell down, cracked, and now it has become like my iPhone X. It has started touching itself. Like, well, that didn't come out too well. Like, it has sort of like, it fell down, it cracked so terribly, and now I can't even unlock it using the pin. Like, even if you unlock with the fingerprint sensor, you still find that you can't use it because it's moving all over the place. If you watch my iPhone X videos, you know it has a ghost on it, and I experienced the same thing. So that's it happening right now. So I went to buy the Huawei Nova 5T again, and it wasn't an easy process. Like, when I got to the shop, or what the supermarket, or what's it called, like the retail store, there were so many phones. Like, there was the Samsung Galaxy A51, A71, the Samsung Galaxy S20, S10, S10e. And at that point, I was very confused, like myself, a mobile phone reviewer, like a mobile phone reviewer. And I was super confused, like, which phone am I going to get? And so I kind of realized that this thing I'm doing is really helpful, because if me, I can get confused when I see so many phones and I'm wondering which one to buy. Initially, I wanted to buy the Samsung Galaxy A51 because of the budget that I had. I wanted to buy a phone which cost less than $400. And the Samsung Galaxy A51, you know, when those phones are on display, like, they look so vibrant. They look really, really good. I don't know why they always look so colorful, so beautiful. And it was looking very good. But I thought about it myself. Like, I've reviewed these phones, I've done a comparison and all. And I know the Huawei Nova 5T is like the best value for money phone anybody can buy right now, especially today, because this phone used to be about $420, but today you can get it for less than $380 on Amazon. Like, for an 8 gig RAM phone, 128 gigs of storage, and one of the fastest processors you're ever going to get on any phone in the world today, selling for less than $400. It's amazing. And it's very amazing because today the phone that everybody's talking about is the iPhone SE. And people are talking about the iPhone SE because of the price. Like, Apple making a phone for $400, it's crazy. It's amazing, especially having a flagship processor. But the Huawei Nova 5T kind of reminds me of the iPhone SE, because this phone, similar to the iPhone SE, is running the best, or the flagship processor that Huawei released in the P30 Pro in 2019. And that's kind of very similar to what Apple is doing with the iPhone SE. They've put in the best processor from 2019, which is the A13 Bionic processor, into the iPhone SE. But then the Huawei Nova 5T is more than just a powerful processor. So today we're going to review the Huawei Nova 5T and give you all the reasons why you need to purchase it now, coming up next.
Are you listening? Damn.
Hi guys, welcome to another edition of Cyber Reviews. Now, if you watch my reviews, and you know I really love the design of the Huawei Nova 5T. This phone used to cost about $400, $420 depending on the region where you purchase it. And I've loved it so much. And over time that I've been using it, I've come to love it even more. So I'm going to tell you the reasons why you should get it, because initially when I reviewed it, I just used it for like a week or two, but now it's been like 3 months, 4 months, and I think that I have formed a better opinion as to why you should get this phone. especially today, because the price on Amazon has dropped so low, and I'm going to leave a link in the description below for why you should get the Huawei Nova 5T. Now, first of all, let's talk about the design. Like, this phone is definitely one of the sexiest phones you're going to find anywhere. So see, you see the way the light catches it and it reflects the light in this gradient pattern. Like, it's just amazing. Like, see, it's crazy, you know. It's beautiful. This thing is an eye turner. Like, if you're using it and you're just walking in town, people will come to you like, what phone are you using? I say, oh, it's a Huawei Nova 5T. Now, talking of the design, one thing I've noticed is it feels quite thick, okay? And I don't know why, but as compared to like even the Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus that I use, it feels very thick. Even compared to like an iPhone 11 Pro Max, it has weight. This phone doesn't feel light at all. It feels very, very thick. Okay. But I think that apart from the thickness, the design is really, really, really great. It's made of both glass at the back and glass in front. And then it has like a hole punch notch, you know, cut out. And it's positioned in a place where it's very good. Like, it's unobtrusive. It doesn't prevent you from enjoying the content you want to enjoy. You can enjoy all the content you want to because the notch is in the corner and not the middle, anywhere like that. On top of the phone, you have like an IR blaster, you have your microphone, you have your speaker grill. At the bottom of the phone, you have a USB port, type C port. So this is where you put your charger, and then that's where you also put your earpiece, which comes bundled with the phone. So talking about bundled, let's see the unboxing experience. Now, when you buy the Huawei Nova 5T, what I bought actually gave me some gift box as well. Okay, Huawei Nova, you can see it clearly written. And so when you open the gift box, you get a Bluetooth speaker, a very colorful purple Bluetooth speaker. Like, it has this prism kind of design going all around it, and it feels kind of heavy. It doesn't feel too plasticky. It feels good. Okay, it came for free when I bought this, so like, I can't really complain. I have a lot of Bluetooth speakers, but this one really feels good, and it will look nice as part of like your desktop decoration and stuff like that. Maybe we'll do a separate review of this, but it came with this. And apart from that, I also got, you know, a charger, which is also USB Type-C for the Bluetooth speaker. And I love the purple color thingy that's going on. Really, really cool. You don't find a lot of purple chargers. Really great. And apart from that, it also comes with a key ring that you can put at the back of your phone and then mount it when you're consuming content. I got all those gifts from the retail shop where I purchased the Huawei Nova 5T. I don't know, in your region, if you buy phones, they give you some of these gifts. Let me know in the comments if where you are watching this video from and if you get gifts when you buy your phones. So let's go back to the Huawei Nova 5T itself. So in the box, you get the phone. Apart from the phone, you also get the earpiece, like I mentioned, which uses USB Type-C. And speaking of Type-C, you also get the USB Type-C charger. And you also get a 22.5 watts fast charging adapter, like really, really fast. Huawei claims that it can charge the phone from like 0 to 50% in 30 minutes. I'm going to do a separate video where we are going to drain this phone of all the battery power, and then we are going to charge it to verify if it truly charges in 30 minutes. Also, you get the manuals and the warranty card and those kind of things which come with your phone. And then you also get a clear plastic case to cover your phone, which I'm using over here. You also get a SIM tray eject, you know, pin to remove your pin. And now let's go back to the design of the phone, because this phone is really great. And I love the position of the fingerprint sensor. Like, it's embedded in the power button, because naturally you always use the power button to unlock your phone. So once you click on it, it unlocks your phone. And this, in my opinion, is like one of the fastest fingerprint sensors I've ever used. It's so fast that it's waiting for you to like touch it at the barest minimum and it's going to unlock. Like, it's crazy. And so still on the right hand side, you have the volume control buttons. On the left hand side, you have the ports where you insert your SIM. This phone uses two SIM cards, okay? So the other thing that you need to know is that there's no space for expandable storage. But I found a really cool hack that I think you can use. So, you know, Android, like the beauty of Android. If it was iOS, maybe I'll be complaining, but this is Android. So you can just connect an OTG cable to it, and then you'd be able to put in like a pen drive, an external hard disk, whatever, and you get your expandable storage. Like you can't be carrying a pen drive all the time, and you can't also charge using a pen drive. But then if you really want to copy files onto and off your phone, you can just connect an OTG, connect a pen drive, and you'd be able to do so. Of course, you can also put the things on the cloud and whatever. So that is something that people are complaining about, the storage space, 128 gig. But I mean, this is a possible workaround. So especially considering the price. Now, at the back of the phone, you have four cameras. You have one 48 megapixel camera, you have a 16 megapixel ultra wide, you have 2 megapixel macro, and then you have a 2 megapixel depth sensing camera. And these cameras are really good. So like if you're comparing it to the iPhone SE, which has only one camera, this one gives you a lot of options, especially the ultra wide, which is something I really like in phones which have come nowadays. It also has night vision camera, and the night vision mode is like one of the best I've seen anywhere. Like when you take pictures at night, this thing looks as bright as day. And I'll be showing you all these pictures so that you can see for yourself and decide if you want to go for it. Now, speaking about the processor, like I said earlier on, this phone comes with the same processor which you find in the Huawei P30 Pro, the high silicon Kirin 980 processor, and that thing is a beast. Like that thing is fast. If you check the benchmark scores of the high silicon Kirin 980 chipset, it's fast, like crazy fast. It's amazing. Like when you're using it coupled with the 8 gigs of RAM on this thing, like everything is a breeze. Like, you know, you can just move everything quickly. You can launch apps, close apps, multitask really, really fast. Another thing I like about it is Android, customizability of Android and all the possible things you can do with Android. Now, because it's a Huawei phone, it comes with a lot of other features. It runs on EMUI, which is Huawei's operating system, but then it also runs on Android. And speaking of Android, you don't have to worry about, you know, having Google Play services when you buy this phone. This one was released before that ban and all, you know, that Chinese controversy and all those things happened. So you can always get this phone, rest assured. You get all the latest Android updates which are supported. You get access to the Google Play Store. You can download all your apps. I have YouTube that I watch. If by now you haven't seen that I really like this phone, then I don't know how to convince you again that this is one of the nicest phones I've ever reviewed. Now, though it has like a glass back, okay, it doesn't have wireless charging. I don't know how important wireless charging is to you, but if you want a wireless charging phone, maybe that's not the phone for you. And apart from that, it's not officially IP67 rated. And I think it's also important for phones to be IP67 or 68 rated for, you know, water resistance, because we are entering a rainy season, at least in the part of the world where I am. And the day I bought this phone, like when I was coming back home, it was raining like cats and dogs. Like it was raining crazy. And when I stepped out of the car, I was trying, you know, I was in a hurry moving all my things on my phones, and my iPhone just fell like into thick water, like running rain water. And I picked it up and it was okay. So I can't really say the same for this, because, you know, like it's not officially IP67 or 68 rated, but then I'm sure it can withstand some splashes of water. But then it will be good if the next version of the Nova phones, you know, come with water resistance and then wireless charging. But then, hey, there's a compromise you need to make for getting such a really good processor, getting 8 gigs RAM, getting an awesome camera, a whole punch cutout, one of the best fingerprint sensors, and one of the nicest, sexiest designs you're ever going to get on any smartphone anywhere in the world, period. Okay, so I'm going to leave a link in the description for where you can get this at the best price today on Amazon. So be sure to check it and I'll be updated. And let me know what you think about the Huawei Nova 5T. Also, as compared to the Mi A3, people are requesting that I do a lot of comparisons between the Huawei Nova 5T and the Mi A3. I'm going to do that. As compared to like the iPhone 11 Pro Max, which one would you prefer? Or even as compared to the Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus, which one would you prefer? Do you use the Huawei Nova 5T? Let me know in the comments. And thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, I'd appreciate it a lot if you press the like button, you shared it, and you left a comment telling me you liked it. And if you're new to my channel, I do mobile phone reviews, mobile app reviews, and I bring to you affordable tech gadgets to help you make an informed decision, because now I understand what it means like to be torn between buying like two different kinds of phones or gadgets, and you really want the best value for money. So I hope you to make like an informed decision whenever you are at that kind of crossroads. So if you like that kind of content, please click on the subscribe button, turn on all notifications so you don't miss any episode. Thanks, baby. Oh, and it's my birthday. Yeah. As at the time you're watching it, it's my birthday. So if you watch to the end, wish me a happy birthday. Say a prayer for me. Thanks, baby. Thanks, Bebre. Thanks, Bebre. Thanks, Bebre.